What is up, you guys? It's Violet Taylor here, and welcome back to Let's Catch a Vibe. Now, I hope everyone's feeling great, feeling amazing, feeling vibey. As you guys can see, we are continuing with the item shop switchover. Now, this will be Monday night, this will be Tuesday night, November the 1st, taking us into early Tuesday morning, which is going to be the 2nd of November. Mad to realise that the 11th is going to be next week already. Anyway, what we're getting in 3, 2, 1... I stopped them for a second. I was like, welcome to chapter 3, 2, 1 again. Let's go! Anyway, as you guys can see, today we had a big update in Fortnite. A lot of quests went live and we had some new skins. So, if you guys didn't know, we have Luke Skywalker and we have Han Solo and Leia Organa now in the item shop. So, jumping straight in, I have already done Is It Not Worth It bundle videos on this, but as you guys can see, the item shop has shrunk. So, we have the man himself, Luke Skywalker, Force-sensitive farmer and galactic hero, part of the original trilogy set, first introduced literally brand new this season. So we've got the default Luke, or as I like to call him, the New Hope Luke. We have the Return of the Jedi Luke, where he's a bit more menacing, but still a badass. And then we have what I like to call the Mandalorian Luke with the cloak, looking absolutely badass. Moving us on to his bat-bling, we have a Star Wars Easter egg here, the New Hope Training Remote. You better get on with your exercises. Really, really cool. Again, loving all the Star Wars quests we've got going at the moment, and especially the Easter eggs. Moving us on to the glider, we have the X-34 Land Speeder. Ever since the XP-38 came out, they just aren't in demand. Now, moving us away from this, we have the emote. We have the little speeder bike. An Imperial Z4Z speeder bike, to be precise. Again, really, really cool. Obviously, very synonymous for Tatooine and stuff like that. And I think, what was the name of the planet? The Ewoks? I can't remember it. Anyway, it's a lot of knowledge in my head. Anyway, moving us on to the harvesting tool, we have the slug thrower rifle. Trusty rifle to have at your side when navigating the Judland Wastes. Again, really, really cool. Moving us on to the second bundle. Yes, we have two. We have the Han Solo and Leia Organa bundle. So, starting us off. We have Han Solo, smuggler, scoundrel, scruffy-looking nerf herder. Made me laugh when she called him that. So yeah, again, we have like the A New Hope Han Solo. We have the Duster Han Solo, which is pretty much like the Empire Strikes Back kind of thing. Correct me if I'm wrong, that might be the wrong movie. But anyway, last but not least, we have the Rebel General. Now, I remember this one definitely being Han from towards the end of The Empire Strikes Back. Because obviously, if you guys don't know, he gets captured by Boba Fett. And then, he breaks free and we have a badass battle on the planet of the Ewoks. Oh, shit, I think I've got that mixed up. I think this is The Empire Strikes Back and this with the coat might be Return of the Jedi. I don't know. My Star Wars knowledge is all mixed up. There's loads of Star Wars knowledge in my head. Anyway, moving us on to the bat bling, of course we have to have the Millennium Falcon. She may not look like much, but she's got it where it counts, kid. If you guys remember, that was an Easter egg to what Han said to Luke. Really, really cool. We've got the Millennium Falcon. We also have the dice there. Let me know in the comments down below if you guys remember where those dice are from as well. Anyway, moving us on to the third skin, we have Leia Organa, Princess, Senator, Rebel Icon. Now, I do want to start with the default here for a second because you do have an option to take her headgear off, which I think is really, really cool because Leia's synonymous for the bangs. The only person that's got like bigger bangs or nicer bangs than her is probably Chun-Li. Anyway, moving us on to the alternate styles, we have the default. We have the Bush disguise, which is really, really cool. Also, but you guys didn't know, you could take the helmet off this one and have the helmet back on. Really, really cool. If you guys remember, this is in Return of the Jedi when she goes out looking for Han. Really, really cool. But then we also have the Bosch disguise, but with the cape. And then again, you can also have the helmet off as well. Really, really cool. I think this is probably the closest you would probably get to Carrie Fisher's face. But overall, absolutely badass. Moving us on to her bat bling, we have, R2-D2. Plucky astromech droid. Man, like, when you think of Star Wars, R2-D2's right up there with probably lightsabers is the first thing you think about. Or Darth Vader. Anyway, really, really cool. Moving us on to the first of two harvesting tools, we have the Electro Staff. One of many in a bounty hunter's arsenal. Secondly, we have the Vibro Staff. Boba Fett, where? Jeez! Moving us away from these, we can have any of these items that you want to buy singularly. So you have Luke, the glider, harvesting tool, emote, again, same with Han and Leia. Moving us on to a brand new skin, as you guys can see, we have the Rest in Peace bundle. So, I am going to be doing an Is It or Is It Not Worth It bundle video on this after this video, so stay tuned for that. But we have the Salvador skin. They say his music soothes lost souls and wandering spirits. So, as you guys can see, we do have a reactive version of the skin. So, we've got the default. We've got the reactive version, as you guys can see. This is looking fuego. Because I think the Day of the Dead comes soon, or it's been already. Anyway, we have the Descend Canto version, or Descend the Candu version. Again, I'm probably butchering that pronunciation. But yeah, you pretty much have the default, and then you have the reactive version. You can also have what seems to be the Cavalera, or Calavera. And then you have the Calavera off, which again is pretty much the face paint, really, on his face. Moving us on to his bat bling, we have the Viuhela de los Muertos. Yeah, I think obviously that means, you know, I think de los Muertos is Day of the Dead, I think. Anyway, always plays the perfect note. Again, as you guys can see, you do have the reactive version. And then you have the Desecanto, or Desecandu version. Again, I apologize for my pronunciation. Last two items, we have the harvesting tool, which is the Bear Full Bellow. Live long on your own accord. Again, we have the reactive version. And then we have the reactive version off, which is pretty cool. Last but not least, we have a wrap. We have the Sugar Skull. It is reactive, I'm assuming, yes. Yeah. So when we fire the weapon, okay, it's not showing me exactly how it's reactive. But overall, it is a really, really cool wrap. Not even going to lie, it is absolutely badass. But yeah, it says the outfit, bat bling, and wrap light up with eliminations. And the Bearful Bellow pickaxe lights up when hitting weak points. Okay. So it is very reactive then, like obviously as you guys can see. But yeah, moving us away from this, guys. Again, I will be doing an Is It or Is It Not Worth It bundle video on this after this item shop. Moving us on to the return of the Ruby skin. Sometimes you gotta shine. Part of the Street Stripes set, first introduced in OG Season X. So we have the Ruby skin. We have the Chill Ruby. And then last but not least, we have the Colourful Ruby. Really, really cool. Moving us on to her bat bling, we have the Red Alert. Let them know what's up. Again, love this bat bling with the knife on the right and the headphones on the left. But then we also have the Feast of Lights version, which pretty much just changes it to blue and white. But again, very subtle change, and I like it. Moving us on to the return of the Stripe Slicer Harvesting Tool. Line them up. First introduced in the OG Season X. So we have the default. And then we have the Frozen Stripe Slicer. Again, really, really cool. Last but not least, it doesn't have an alternate style, but it is really, really cool. We have the Sky Stripe Glider. Signature Stripe Glider. Again, really, really cool. Absolutely love this one. Moving us on to the return of the Henchman Bundle. As you guys can see, we have two versions. We have the default, and then we have the summer versions where they have shorts. Moving us on to the return of the Sicker Bundle, which is really, really cool. Now, a bit of a fun fact behind this, when the skin came out, a subscriber to my channel actually gifted me the skin. So it came with the bat bling, which I really, really do appreciate. You know who you are. Might have been on my old channel, so I don't know if you subscribed to this one. But anyway, shout out to you. I did buy the harvesting tool, and what I feel is one of the, not the best, but one of the badass gliders in the game, which is the Cerberus. But yeah, moving us on to the return of the daily store. We've got some really, really cool items in here. Starting us off, we have the return of the Dazzler skin. The Dominator of Dusty Depot. Part of the Hyper set, first introduced in the OG Season 2. Looking really, really cool. Moving us on to the return of the Slumber skin. It's Time to Say Goodnight. Part of the Dreamy Days set, first introduced in the OG Season X. So we've got the default, which is the ninja, and then we have the pillow version, which, I don't know, I like the pillow version more, just because it looks really, really comfy. Moving us on to the bat bling, we have the dreamer. So, we pretty much have the default, which is purple-based, and then we have the blue, which is the alternate, again, pretty much self-explanatory, but really, really cool. Everybody as a baby's had one of those, like, star mobiles and stuff like that. Anyway, moving us on to the daily store, we have the return of the Carnival Flowers reactive and animated wrap. So, starting us off, we have the default here, as you guys can see. Now, the reactive wrap animates when firing the weapon, so if we trigger it, jeez, switches the color palette there. So, this is part of the Carnival 2020 set, first introduced in Chapter 2, Season 2. You already know this is my favorite season. So yeah, we have some really, really cool styles for this. Absolutely badass. It's kind of trippy when you look at it for so long. Moving us on to the return of the Plunger. The competition is Circling the Drain. First introduced in OG Season 2. Again, very, very OG. Everybody and their mama owns this. I originally own this. Moving us on to the return of the last two items, we have the Lazy Shuffle. Keep it lazy. First introduced in OG Season 7. Again, another emote that I haven't seen return in a while. We have the Breakpoint emote. Give him a break. First introduced in OG Season 3. That's probably the opposite of a Kit Kat. You just give him a break and don't actually give him a break with a Kit Kat. Anyway, moving us on to the return of the remaining bundles in the item shop. These will have been here over a week, maybe a couple of days. So anyway, we have Black Adam. Then we move on to Mr. Meeseeks. We have Queen Summer. We have Mecha Morty. And then last but not least, we have these special offers and bundles. But yeah, guys, hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to smash that like button. If you didn't enjoy the video, let me know in the comments down below why you didn't like the video. Also, let me know what is your favorite item from tonight's item shop. And number two, which is your favorite Star Wars skin. So, if you are new to the channel, don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you're new and join the team Let's Catch a Vibe. Also, if you are new, please don't forget to switch on the bell notifications to get notified as soon as I upload. But, more importantly, don't forget to stay vibey, and I'll catch you all in a galaxy far, far away. Peace!